Hi there, and welcome to the first edition of The Works in 2024. I'm Ben Che.
And I'm Ben Peltier. With the beginning of the new year, we're featuring a couple of art organizations that have anniversaries to celebrate.
One of them is the Hong Kong Composers Guild. On January the 12th, the Guild is presenting the second of three concerts in a festival to celebrate musical creativity. One group taking part is the Hong Kong Gaudeamus Dunhuang Ensemble, members of which will be here later to tell us more.
The Jockey Club Creative Arts Center is also celebrating an anniversary, its 15th, and it's doing so by mounting an exhibition featuring works by many of the artists who work in its studios.
In 2024, the Jockey Club Creative Arts Center, or JCCAC, in Shek Kit Mei celebrates the 15th anniversary of its establishment in 2008. To mark the occasion, it's entering the year with an exhibition entitled I'm Here. On show are works by more than 40 artists. The display spans the gallery floors and other parts of the building. Its focus is existence itself.
The展覽的題目就叫做我在。我在來自笛卡爾那句大家都認識的，我思故我在。但對於藝術家來說，其實是我創作故我在。所以用了一個主題，其實就希望告訴觀眾，我們藝術家就在這裡創作，大家來欣賞一下我們最新的傑作。JCCAC本身的藝術家年齡層很闊的。 由20多歲到70歲都有，但而佢哋做嘅媒體力都好廣泛嘅，所以我哋就盡量發揮佢哋嘅專長啦，咁啊就喺唔同嘅地方都用咗出嚟做展覽。譬如我背後大家睇到嘅就係一個壁畫啦，橫跨3層嘅，有一啲專係做 graffiti 嘅，或者係擅長於畫大作品嘅，咁就會喺一啲牆度做壁畫啦。譬如中庭嘅嗰度就有啲大型嘅雕塑啦。
Cross-media artist Phoebe Hoy is one of the center's longest-standing tenants. Inspired by the instantaneous and random interactions she's had with visitors while working here, she's presenting a work that brings together scientific research and technologies such as machine learning to mimic the faces of visitors.
我喺中心呢度租工作室嘅時候咧，尤其是早期嘅階段啦，其實好多嚟參觀嘅觀眾咧，可能佢哋都比較陌生，即係唔知道點樣去到藝術家工作室其實應該係點㗎。咁好多時佢哋會望住我哋做嘢啦，或者係佢會唔敲門就衝入嚟，就會問我哋做緊啲咩嘢啦。 咁呢個都係啲好得意嘅一個體驗嚟㗎。咁我就好想喺今次15周年嘅呢個作品入面咧，其實係回應翻觀眾同我互動嘅一啲部分，所以先至會諗到啊，其實我係會用一個 camera 去捕捉咗觀眾嘅容貌。咁入面係會有一支筆喺度啦。咁而佢畫緊嘅 畫面咧，其實就係我前一日收集翻嚟觀眾容貌嘅一啲數據。因為細個其實即係其他人玩燈籠咧，其實佢哋就好正路咁樣，即係攞住個燈籠去玩。但我係會拆開佢哋即係嗰啲電係點樣薄啊，又會嘗試即係可唔可以將個燈擠咗喺自己間房嗰度，有啲唔同嘅燈效啊，又撈埋啲 LEGO 睇下會唔會有啲 light show 整到出嚟。即係我係會拆開啲嘢嚟玩嘅一個細路仔嚟嘅。 咁當然都係好得人驚㗎啦，我相信對於父母嘅嚟講，其實我自己最初介呢個空間嘅時候，就覺得呢一個部分其實係類似一個 workshop 嘅 space 啦。咁所以你會見到好多五花八門嘅工具會喺度啦，好多唔同 size 嘅螺絲啦，即係一定嘅銅嘅螺絲啦，有啲 circuit board。 仲有勁多 model 啦，因為其實我真係好中意玩 model， 即係所以變咗唔同款嘅 model 係喺上邊咁樣嘅。咁另外就有一啲木工嘅工具啦，有 drill press 啦，有 miter saw 啦，另外仲有啲 sander 同埋 nail gun 咁。我其實喺 JCCAC 開始我嘅工作室咧，大概都有10幾年嘅時間。 有時我都會想像，即係如果我冇呢個工作室，其實我會唔會而家都仲做緊創作？其實我可能我未必好肯定我自己可以堅持，但係我覺得每一次我翻嚟工作室做嘢嘅時候，就算工作室嘅燈、其他工作室燈有冇開都好，但我會知道其實有成條村嘅人都係一齊好努力咁創作緊嘅時候，好似冇咁孤單咁樣。
Apart from the exhibition, there are programs on making art, workshops, and live performances. The center has also organized some studio tours to help the public learn more about the building.
So, actually, these are a lot of times when I was studying. But when I graduated, I started.
One place included in the tour is the studio of ceramic artist Muses C. So,
this is our artist Muses.
Let Muses 介紹下佢嘅 studio。 今個暑假啦，咁 JCCAC 就俾咗一個 funding 我啦，我就去咗景德鎮嘅樂天陶社做 residence。 今個晏晝嘅分享咧，就會一啲觀眾過嚟啦，我會俾啲相去睇啦，就係關於景德鎮裏邊嘅所見所聞啦，咁同埋會俾一啲舞具佢哋睇嘅。其實我一路嘅 practice 都係想嘗試透過陶瓷啦，去揾一啲特別嘅可能性嘅，即係可能唔同嘅可能性，除咗功能性嘅作品以外啦。咁所以我比較多係做一啲ceramics 嘅 sculpture 嘅。咁今次我就用咗攪胎嘅方法，一個比較傳統嘅方法咧，去做一啲 pattern 啦。咁我而今次就做咗格仔嘅 pattern。嘗試去用唔同嘅顏色嘅色泥配搭嘅做嘅格仔布，咁因為佢做嘅形態係具立體啦，而格仔咧亦都令到嗰個立體強啲嘅，咁我覺得出到嚟效果幾有趣嘅。咁有啲係掛牆啦，有啲就係擺咗喺個 stand 上邊。除咗係一啲 studio practice 做一啲立體嘅作品之外咧，其實我都會做一啲功能性嘅嘢嘅，咁譬如花瓶啊，或者餐具啦，或者茶具啦，譬如呢一種嘅花瓶啦，咁我會中意咧做一啲嘅功能性嘅作品咧，就會拎去流浮山做柴燒咯。呢個架都會係擺一啲茶具啊、餐具嘅嘢嘅。陶瓷咧係直接 touch 嘅，咁嗰個係好直接嘅一個嘅 practice 咯。我係。覺得好有趣，同埋其實 ceramics 佢裏邊有好多嘅知識嘅，咁需要好長時間去 study， 譬如釉藥啦、泥嘅成分啦，或者佢能夠塑形嘅方法啦，我一路都 keep 住學緊嘅。其實我喺度好長時間咧去教一啲 workshop 嘅，咁裏邊有唔同嘅公眾會過嚟啦，咁就會學拉杯啦、學手捏啦，咁依家都有嘅，咁但係個時間就可能一兩個星期會有一節課，但係同時間我就長咗時間做自己嘅創作咯，咁佢亦都係一個比較 me time 嘅地方。我都希望繼續喺度嘅，即係都希望JCCAC 都容讓我繼續用呢個空間去做創作啦。
其實對香港藝術家嚟講咧，其實最欠缺嘅就係空間，係平嘅空間，因為大部分嘅工廠大廈咧，其實租金都相當貴。其實而家香港嚟講咧，除咗 JCCAC 依一度提供到百幾個工作室之外咧，其他嗰啲提供嘅數量係冇咁大嘅，譬如 ADC 都有，但係個數量少好多。咁所以依度係已經成為香港一個好重要培育年輕藝術家嘅地方。
WKM Gallery opened in Wong Chuk Hang last November. It's named after its founder, William Kayne Mukai, who has both Japanese and French roots and wants a gallery to bring together a range of cultures. The 2,600 square foot space is divided into four zones based on the Japanese design concept of ma, which roughly translates to negative space. The idea is to create a sense of gap or pause in which to create new meaning. The inaugural exhibition, Metamorphosis, Japan's Evolving Society, features works by 12 contemporary Japanese artists in a variety of media, including photography, painting, sculpture, and embroidery. The gallery says its space is not just a place to display art. It also plans to develop outreach programs to reach a broader audience.
Welcome back. Celebrating its 40th anniversary, the Hong Kong Composers Guild is presenting a festival celebrating contemporary music that includes three concerts. Those concerts feature 26 pieces of recent music, three of which are commissioned from local composers. One group taking part in the second concert of the series is the Hong Kong Gaudeamus Dunhuang Ensemble. Some of its members are with us to tell us more.
Members of the Hong Kong Gaudeamus Dunhuang Ensemble, welcome to The Works. So, as the conductor of this concert, tell us a bit more about the actual concert and give us an overview. What's the concert about?
To celebrate the 40th anniversary of the Hong Kong Composers Guild, we have a concert series, and the second one is presented by us. We transcend the old legacy into new, and then reinterpret or reinvent the sound or the material from the past and put it into a contemporary context and writing something new. And that is the core value of the concert.
Right. Yeah. And in this concert, you'll be playing seven original pieces, right? One of which is commissioned. Can you tell me about these compositions or pieces?
I would say all of them is... they got their inspiration from the past. They adopted many materials, no matter West or East, and then put it into a contemporary context. For example, there is a piece which is written for a peipa and an ensemble. And the peipa is one of the most traditional instrument in Chinese culture. And the piece, but the piece itself is a rock and roll music. Oh, okay. And the composer is quite successfully adopted the technique of the peipa to write a modern and exciting piece. So I think that is the quite a typical example of our concert, which is there are a lot of different style, and we get inspiration from the past, and then we do something new and present it in a complete new way.
Right. Yeah. So let's talk a little bit about the actual name of the ensemble, the Hong Kong Gaudeamus Dunhuang Ensemble. Where does the name come from, and what is the meaning behind the name?
Actually, the word, I think, Gaudeamus is a little bit unfamiliar when you heard the name. But actually, that word we search online, it means the ancient form of music ensemble, and which is in Chinese called 乐府. So we want to adopt the name because that we are a group of very special, having special instrumentation, because the you can see that we don't have the bow instrument, the bow strings instruments. Right. So because we adopt the idea from the Dunhuang Mogao grottos, and then we see that in the all the murals that we pick the most important instruments, and then we put it into our ensemble. So we want something to be sounds like Asian. So we use the name Gaudeamus. So and then Dunhuang is the origin from our all the musical ideas.
Right. And can you tell us a bit more about the instrumentation? I mean, you're holding something there, Jenny, and then we have something similar to a harp. Perhaps tell us about the instrumentation in the ensemble.
Okay, because I played this one. This is what we call Hong Hao, and you can translate it in like Chinese harp in English. And then this is kind of a new invention, because we the Hong Hao in the ancient time maybe only having one set of strings, but now you can see we have two sets. So we try to upgrade the instrument by using adding in some what we called Chinese style and then the Chinese technique. So this instrument actually is not from China, because it came from the ancient Persia. So along the Silk Road, so many instruments transform their origin from a Western kind into a Chinese kind, and this one is a very special one and a very typical example.
Right.
Yes.
And then what about the other instruments? These are bamboo clappers. Is that a traditional Chinese instrument?
It is one of the traditional instruments. I think it's kind of like a, we perform mostly with in Chinese folk music. You can see it on the street. It's most popular in Tang Dynasty, I think. And it usually, the form of music with this bamboo clappers is original for storytelling. It's actually a wooden one. Mm-hmm. And so we want to get some more inspiration with other different similar kind, and this is the one we think is really suited the idea of the song. So right. Here, this is the one. Yeah. And we also have different kind of, we have three types mostly. We have the plug strings, and we also have percussions, and also and woodwinds.
Woodwind as well.
Yeah,
right.
Yeah,
but you were saying no bow
no strings. No bow strings, yes.
Right. So it sounds like, I mean, you know, you want to take things from the past, from the legacy, and present it in a modern kind of way. So are there any limitations to what the ensemble can play?
Because the most typical instrumentation for Chinese music is kind of like, we have four family. Just like what Sylvia had said, the plug strings instrument, the bow strings, and then the woodwind, and then the percussion instrument. But for us, because we're adopting to the instrumentation we see in the grotto, that means we didn't have the bow instrument. Therefore, we have to tailor-make the music for the ensemble because of the not quite a typical instrumentation. Mm. Yeah.
Okay. Well, finally, you're here today. Four of the musicians will be performing a piece, and this piece I know you won't be playing in the concert, but it's a signature piece of the ensemble. So tell me a bit more about this piece.
The name of the piece is called The Fugue in C Major. And but in Chinese, it's called 水谷子. 水谷子 is one of the 25 ancient pipa scores that people found in Dunhuang Grotto. And it's basically a single line melodies date back in Tang Dynasty. And I write a fugue on it. So the structure itself tells the story of the Grotto.
Yeah. Right. Okay. Well, thank you all of you for coming in today, and I look forward to hearing the piece.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.